各位弟兄姐妹们，主里平安。这时刻，我们安静我们的心，无论什么问题，放下，仰望我们的天父，让我们的心是诚然向神祈求。我们要以心里诚实敬拜他，把一切的重担忧虑卸下，交托于神。在患难之中，我们依然要仰望我们的神。我相信在这时代，神在考验我们对他真实的爱。我们时常我们自己心里说什么，嘴里讲什么，我们很多时候不明白。神要我们心跟嘴要一致的，而不是心里想一套，嘴里说一套，不行。所以弟兄姐妹们，我很慎重的来劝导弟兄姐妹们，神一直叫我们要心灵和诚实敬拜他，倒空自己。来到神面前就是要倒空自己，一切的问题难处，当我们跟神对齐，一切的难处神自己来为我们伸冤，为我们的安排，他会带领度过难处。神是信实的，所以我们要以心灵诚实敬拜他。我劝大家安静我们的心，神要我们一颗敬畏他的心，诚心诚意诚人的心来献上，献上我们甘心的祭来敬拜我们的神。这时刻我奉耶稣的名，我们今天的聚会开始了，我们来宣读神的话，诗篇四十一，一到十一节。我们大家肃立。我们有口的，我们就一起开口宣告读神的话。成为我们的力量，成为我们的帮助。好，我曾四十一诗篇四十啊 ，OK，sorry， 我曾耐心等候耶和华，他垂听我的呼求，他从祸坑里，从雨里中。把我拉上来，使我的脚立在磐石上，使我脚步稳当。他使我口唱新歌，就是赞美我们神的话。许多人必看见而惧怕，并要依靠耶和华。那依靠耶和华，不理会狂傲和偏向虚假之辈的，这人便为有福。耶和华我的神啊，你所行的奇事，比你向我们所怀的意念甚多，不能向你成名。若要成名，奇事不可胜数。祭物和礼物你不喜悦，你已经开通我的耳朵，犯祭和赎罪祭非你所要。那时我说，看啊，我来了，我的事在经卷上已经记载了。我的神啊，我乐意照你的旨意行，你的律法在我心里。我在大会中宣传公义的佳音，我必不止住我的嘴唇。耶和华，这是你所知道的， 我未曾把你的公义藏在心里，我已成名你的信实和你的救恩。我在大会中未曾隐瞒你的慈爱和诚实。阿们。耶和华，求你不要向我止住你的慈悲，愿你的慈爱和诚实常常保佑我。阿们。我们同心祷告。天父，你是慈爱怜悯的神，当我们众弟兄姐妹们在这里奉你的名而聚集，你是我们，你是教会的头，我们只不过是你的肢体，是你的儿女，我们能够欢喜快乐还有生命气息来到你面前歌颂赞美敬拜你。主，我们献上感恩，是你的恩典与怜悯的带领，让我们每一天能够度过艰难的道路，进入你得胜的道路。主啊，因为你是世平安的神，你经受世界有苦难，只有在你里面有平安。我们感谢你天父啊，我们只有感恩来到你施恩宝座前，祷告于你，唱诗赞美歌颂你奇妙的恩典。天父们，谢谢你，但愿这时刻你圣灵运行在我们当中，长成居所会在这个地方，宝血洁净遮盖我们每一个你的儿女们。主啊，让我们每一天的生活有你的陪伴，昼夜蒙福，日夜蒙福，因为你应许给我们躲在你的翅膀荫下，你必赐给我们平安。哈利路亚，我们赞美你，主啊，你如此的爱我们，珍顾我们，我们献上感恩。主啊，今天的聚会从头到末你掌权在当中，引领我们一下时间，恩膏你仆人的口。Tell us, Pastor, tell us, 主耶稣，你透过他的口向我们众弟兄说我们的问题。主耶稣啊，我们需要你来成名，我们在你的面前有什么不义吗？主啊，你就是要我们以心里诚实敬拜你，怜悯我们吧，医治我们，我们需要你来带领我们每一天的道路，哦，给我们有一个正确的方向，走在你喜悦的道路上，蒙你的带领与祝福。主啊，我们感谢你，把一切荣耀归给你，祷告来奉耶稣基督名求，阿们。
弟兄姐妹，祝你平安 ，Shalom, brothers and sisters。好，让我们一起开口大声来敬拜神，好吗？我们一起开心的来朝见荣耀的君王 ，Amen。一切歌颂赞美，让我们一起拍手。 来敬拜我们的神，我们要宣告今天早上大山要来为我们挪开所有生命的阻拦，今天神都要把它切断，好吗？一起拍手。
虽然道路崎岖，困难险阻，但我心中知道你一直都在。不能明白为何，但知重担，但我心中相信你一直牵着我。
我们来宣告大山，
大山为我挪开，大海有路前来，我要的是宣告耶稣你一直都在，你手上的钉痕彰显十字架的爱，我要的是宣告耶稣你一直都在。
让我们唱更大声一点哦，奇迹，好不好？我们要大声的宣告，今天神要不停来祝福我们的家，祝福我们的生命，甚至祝福我们的教会，祝福曼荣县，好不好？我们一起大声开口来唱，虽然，准备好了吗？
虽然道路崎岖，困难险阻，但我心中知道。不能明白为何，但知重担，但我始终相信你一直牵着我。
大山，
大山为我挪开门，大海犹如之来，我要的是信靠耶稣直到在，你手上的钉痕彰显十字架的爱，我要的是宣告耶稣你一直都在。
我们先来宣告神你的话，
让我明白你爱我永不更改，你保守我的心怀，紧握你双手不放开。
神你的话，
你的话让我明白你爱我永不更改，你保守我的心怀，紧握你双手我不放开，大山为我挪开，
宣告，
大海涌入起来，我要的是宣告耶稣你一直都在，你手上的钉痕彰显世界的爱，我要的是宣告耶稣你一直都在。
我要大声，
我要的是宣告耶稣
生命得胜，因为他在十字架已经为我们复活了。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。是的，耶稣，谢谢你，我们这里的每一个人儿子，在为我们复活。主要谢谢你，我们做最好的见证。主要你的十字架，是我们恩典的记号。 子啊，你告诉我们这一条信仰的道路是一条恩典之路，主啊，因此今天早上，主啊，我们要打开心门，来向你领受，勇敢的接受你要给我们的祝福。我们继续心灵和诚实来敬拜你，主啊，今天早上你要来充满我们这里的每一个人，主啊，因为你要对我们的心灵来说话，主啊，你的灵粮要来填满我们枯干的心灵，主啊，你说你的羊儿会认得你的声音。主啊，祷告今天我们要继续要来分辨认得主你对我们的说话。谢谢你耶稣，主啊，今天早上当我们的手举高的时候，主啊，你就要来充满我们，不停地来更新我们的生命，翻转我们的生命，甚至翻转我们的教会，翻转曼荣教区的每一间教会，主啊，让我们能够更勇敢地来为你而活。耶稣，谢谢你。
主，我来寻求你的面，求你充满我，来充满我。主，我渴慕你的同在，求你接近我，来充满我。
主，
主，我来寻求你的面，求你充满我，来充满我，充满我。主，我渴慕你的同在，求你接近我，来充满我。
我们举起手，
耶稣，耶稣，耶稣，耶稣，你的宝血洗净我，耶稣，耶稣，耶稣，耶稣，你just blood.
主啊，你的十字架永远都是我们得救的记号，永远都是我们的荣耀。耶稣，谢谢你。所有的尊贵权柄和荣耀都归给你，主啊，谢谢你，主啊，唯有你配得我们献上全心全意在你的面前，主啊，唯有你配得我们献上最好的敬拜给你，主啊，因为这是一个最美的祭，主啊，愿你悦纳今天早上我们的敬拜，主啊，愿你继续的对我们的生命来说话，主啊，我祷告以下的聚会时间，主啊，你要开启我们属灵的眼睛、属灵的耳朵，还有属灵心，让我们能够把你的话听进里面，听进心里面，刻在心板上，让我们能够让你的话语继续来刚强我们每一天的生活。主啊，我祷告，我们每一天的生活都要有你的同在。主啊，因为有你的同在，主啊，我们的生命何等的蒙福，让我们的生命能够继续祝福我们身边的人，甚至祝福我们的教会，甚至祝福曼荣教区的每一个还没有信主的人，包括我们家里人，包括我们的亲戚。主啊，我们将所有的困难都仰望交托在你的里面。主啊，因为你是听我们祷告的神，耶稣，谢谢你的信实和良善，谢谢你的怜悯在我们的生命当中。主啊，我们要继续的高举你的名，主啊，唯有你配得。谢谢你耶稣，谢谢你耶稣，我们感谢祷告乃是奉靠我主耶稣最宝贵的名求，阿们。让我们将所有的尊贵荣耀归给神，哈利路亚。让我们预备心来唱圣唱诗歌，来领受圣餐。 A wonderful Savior, with numberless blessings.
rapture. Oh, glory to God, for such a Redeemer as mine. He had my soul in the cradle of the rock that shadows the dry, dusty
姐妹，请坐。
此刻，请大家安静，我们的心，预备好我们的心，来领受这圣餐。预备好我们的心，领受圣餐。领受圣餐是来感恩，来纪念耶稣他救赎的大爱，他舍身流血在十字架上，这是为了要赦免我们的罪。所以我们在神面前，我们要真实悔罪，改过自新，遵行神的道。阿们。 什么人没有拿到圣餐的？你们举手。没有拿到饼跟杯的，举手举手。大家肃立。在哥林多前书十一章二十三到二十六节，圣经的话语如此说：我当日传给你们的，原是从主领受的，就是主耶稣被卖的那一夜，拿起杯来就祝谢，掰开。耶稣说：这是我的身体，为你们舍的，你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。饭后，耶稣也照样拿起杯来说：这杯是用我的血所立的新约，你们每逢喝的时候要如此行，为的是纪念我。所以你们每逢吃这饼喝这杯，是表明主的死，只等到他来。阿们。我们同心祷告。永生神的儿子耶稣基督，你是我们的救主，你是我们的救赎主，是你拯救我们从罪恶里面，把我们带进那光明之路。主，我们感谢你，谢谢你的大爱，谢谢你的怜悯，也谢谢你的救赎。你就是世界的光，愿你的光来照亮我们。主啊，让我们心中有什么暗恋的，而且不讨神喜悦的，完全要脱离我们的身上，因为我们身体是神你的殿。主，你来洁净我们，更新我们，圣灵充满我们，让我们在每一天生活靠主而得胜又得胜。主，我们感谢，这是我们的盼望，因为你是永远是我们的救主，是我们的依靠。我们感谢你，我们要称颂你，把一切荣耀归给你。祷告来奉耶稣基督名求，阿们。大家请坐。
弟兄姐妹，大家主里平安。
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
高兴看到大家再次回到神的殿中，一起来敬拜上帝。
Glad to see all of you gathered together this morning.
我们感谢主。那现在有一些的报告，好
啊。There are some announcements.
那报告之前，其实有一些新来的朋友或者很久没有来的朋友，我们也欢迎你们哈。
We'd like to welcome those who are new in this morning, or those who have not been here for quite some time.
大家也给自己一个这个欢迎的掌声哈。
So, please give yourself a loud applause.
感谢主，在主里我们是一家人哈。
So we are one family in Christ.
这个主日学待会就可以开始一步去这个。
Children church, you now you can proceed to the secondary hall.
All right, 下一章。
Next.
这个有慕道基础课程哈，今天在11:30崇拜过后，刚刚洗礼的 或者要准备要洗礼的，或者洗礼了还没有不太明白一些圣经的教导的，都可以去。
Foundation course. So at 11:30 this morning, this at the secondary hall for those who are just baptized or about to be baptized, or you want to know about this Christ, you can always join.
我鼓励更多的弟兄姐妹们能够去哈，因为在真道上我们要清楚知道我们相信的是谁。
I personally encourage brothers and sisters to go and join and to know more about this this faith.
一定要信得清楚，信得明白。
You need to be very sure and clear about what you are believing.
不是每个星期来做礼拜哈。
And not just to warm up the seat here.
星期二有这个晚祷会。
Tuesday we have this prayer night.
也鼓励更多弟兄姐妹一起来参加。
So encourage more brothers and sisters to participate.
你相信祷告有力量吗？
Do you believe there's a power in prayer?
那还有查经班星期三晚上。
Bible class on Wednesday night.
八点钟。
8 p.m.
透过这个 Zoom 由周淑珍传道带领。
Through Zoom conducted by Pastor Do Su Ting.
那接下来这个星期四下午三点。
Thursday 3 p.m.
由周淑珍传道带领的这个使徒保罗生平与书信课程。
Also, these are conducted by Pastor Do Su Ting on the course of Apostle Paul's life and his letters.
欢迎大家抽空时间，一些年长的有时间上比较好安排的，都可以来参加，鼓励你们来。
So please take time off to come and join.
接下来这个乐洋洋哈，乐洋洋，我们星期四星期六4:30到6:00。
Joy Garden every Saturday 4:30 to 6 p.m.
你家如果有小孩4到12岁的，欢迎你带他们来。
If you have children aged 4 to 12, so please and bring them along.
这个星期六的这个主题是两个家庭。
So theme for this Saturday one is two families.
OK, 欢迎你们带孩子来哈。
Welcome to join.
那其他的聚会照旧。
Other activities as usual.
这个每天早上荣耀堂有这个晨祷会啊。
Every morning we have this prayer.
OK. 那这个链接那些呢，如果你没有这个 Shekinah Family 的这个sharing 的 group, 你可以找Brother Yap 啊，叫他把你的电话加上去。
So if you are not in the Shekinah Family sharing group, you can always contact this sister Annie.
如果在座你知道一些朋友他没有这个在 group 里面呢，你也可以通知我们，我们也愿意把他加在我们 group 里面，所以那些 linkage 都容易的交到给他们哈。
If you happen to know your friends that not belong to this group, you can let us know so that we will add them, so that they will know all the this about the news of Shekinah family.
这个牧区议会的报告8月28号要交上来哈，所有的
local church conference annual report need to submit before today 8th of August.
开会是9月4号。
Meeting is on the 4th of September.
OK, 接下来这个奉献箱在门口哈。
Offering box right at the entrance.
奉献是每个基督徒的这个权利。
It's a duty of every Christian.
So it's a privilege also,
It is a privilege to do so.
然后还有这个线上的在这个这里哈。
You can also do it online, and please take down the bank account number.
新朋友，你还没有认识主的，不需要参与奉献吗？
If you are not a believer yet, you can always refrain from doing so.
我们欢迎你快快成为这个基督徒，明白神的救恩，然后也可以一起来奉献。
We like you. We are always welcome to be a believer as soon as possible.
下一个还有什么吗？
Is there any other announcements?
没有了，我们就把时间交给倪长老。
And now I'd like to invite our Deng Ai.
Shalom, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome back to the house of the Lord.
弟兄姐妹们，主内平安，欢迎回到神的殿中。
We experience the fullness of joy in His presence as we worship Him.
但愿你能够享受到与神同在的那种的喜乐呢。
And let the joy of the Lord be your strength.
让神的喜乐成为你的力量。
We are very happy this morning to have one of God's choicest servants to come to Manjung and to Shekinah in particular.
很高兴今天早上神差遣他其中一个最佳的仆人来我们当中来曼谷区，尤其是来到这个荣耀堂跟大家分享。
Pastor Terence Jedidiah Poe.
牧师就是Terence Jedidiah Poe.
He has a rare experience of being a visitor to hell.
他曾经有这样的经验，有去到地狱的。
Fortunately, he was not helped a prisoner in that place.
幸运的，他没有成为地狱的被那个囚者。
Subsequently, he also had an encounter in a visit to heaven.
之后呢，他又有一个权利去到这个天堂，成为那边一个游客。
Pastor Terence is the founder and director of Asia Revival Center Penang.
他是槟城，又是就是创办人，就是 Asia Revival 亚洲复兴这个中心的创办人。
He also founded two other international organizations.
他还有创办了两个国际的这个组织。
Unite and ignite Asia.
就是说，团结起来，燃烧这个亚洲。
And Tons of Fire International.
还有这个国际这个燃烧。
God has also blessed him with the writing skills. He's the author of several books.
神也给他有写作的这个能力，他写了许多本书。
The wisdom to expound very tough subjects of the scriptures in very simple language with authority, clarity, and simplicity for easy reading.
很艰难的圣经的那个难题，他就用很简单、很容易的文字把它给写出来。
It's very kindly brought along the books that they're the site there. You can buy them.
他所写作的书在那边柜台上，你们可以购买哦。
God has blessed him with a wife who is a ministry partner, Lee Tiara Terry.
他亲爱的太太也跟他一起的同工。
Two sons, Maranatha and Benjamin.
还有两位这个儿子哦。
He has a burden to come to this town to help us to redig the wells of revival.
他有这样的负担来到这个曼谷城市，要挖掘那个复兴的井。
And yesterday there was a lunch hosted by us to all the Manjung pastors and key lay people. There were 10 tables.
昨天下午我们有午餐。就包括这个曼谷区的不同教会的那牧师跟领袖。
We have focused for a long time the first objective of the Shekinah, that is to establish a Christ-centered, Bible-based, and Holy Spirit-empowered church to reach the people in Manjung and regions beyond as disciples for Jesus Christ.
我们的目标，我们要谈曾经设下的就是。让曼园成为一个以基督为中心，以圣灵，以那个圣经为根基，以及充满圣灵能力的教会啊，在这个曼园区。
The second objective is to stimulate revival in Manjung.
一个目标就是使曼中大复兴哦。
And this is the beginning where we have embarked on this second objective.
这个就是我们朝着第二个。目标是个刚刚是开始哦。
Pastor Terence described himself as God's alarm clock.
Pastor Terence 就是说他把他自己描写说是神的这个闹钟啊。
It is truly an alarm clock of a revivalist that vibrates with explosive spiritual power with the prophetic and apostolic cutting edge.
真正的在这个复兴这个层次来讲，它真的是一个脑中把这个意思说要做大复兴的这个声音给响起来了。
Put our hands together and welcome him to share with us the prophetic message that God has in store for us and to minister to us.
欢迎他。
I feel like singing.
我想很想唱歌哈。
I am a man who is led by the Holy Spirit.
我是跟着圣灵的引导生活的一个人。
The Holy Spirit is my best friend.
圣灵是我最好的朋友。
Every day before I leave my bed, I will say good morning to you, Holy Spirit.
早晨起来，我还没有起床的时候，我都会说圣灵早上好。
Before I leave my house, I will put my hand on the door and I say, Lord, I'm not going to go out unless you follow me.
所以我会早晨起来告诉神，我出门之前，神，如果你没有跟着我的话，我就不出门。
And when he follows you everywhere you go, you walk under an open heaven.
当神圣灵与你同在，你到哪里的话，那里都是天堂啊。
And when you walk under an open heaven, God goes before you, God stands behind you, and God walks beside you.
当你到这个有圣灵同在，就是有神的，就围绕着你，保护着你。
There was one time someone gave me a word, a prophetic word.
有一次有人给我一个限制性的一句话。
She said, I saw COVID-19 when he comes near you, COVID-19 makes U-turn.
她说好像看到 COVID-19 来到你跟前的时候，她做了一个 U-转。
Are you all awake here?
你们清醒吗？
Not that we cannot fall sick because we have a human body.
不是说我们不会生病，因为我们还是人啊。
But even though we may fall sick, but God will heal us.
就总变我们生病了，但是即便我们生病，神会医治我们。
And wherever we go, we know that His protection surround us, His favor surround us like a shield. That Psalms 5 verse 12.
这个诗篇五章十二节这么说，我们无论到哪里去，耶和华的保护，他的这个盾牌都围绕着我们。
So wherever I travel, if I go into the jungles, if I go up the mountains, if I go to the cities, or I go to different nations, I know that the Lord my God walks beside me and His favor surrounds me、
Amen.
Like a shield.
无论我到哪里去，到深山野林，到大城市，到哪一个地方去牧会牧养的时候，我知道神的的确确在保护着我们。
And you have the same favor, the same privilege, because we are the family of Jesus. Amen.
其实你和我都有一样的这个privilege, 一个特权我们都是在主里是一家人。
It's very important that we know who we are and we know who our Father is.
So, 其实非常重要的，我们能够知道我们是谁，我们真正的身份，然后我们的天父是谁。
And when you know who you are, the devil cannot bully you.
当你真正确确知道你的身份的时候，这个恶者不能够欺负你。
But demons will flee from you whenever they see you.
这个撒旦会离你而去。
Remember, there was a chapter in the book of Acts where the sons of Sceva they were demonized, and this person came, you know, and he wants to cast out the demons, and the demons say, "Who are you, Jesus? I know, Paul, I know, but who are you?"
就有一个人被赶鬼的时候，那个被附身的那个鬼的，他就说：“哎，你是谁？我认识耶稣，我认识保罗，但是你是谁
？”If you walk in the power and the authority of Christ, and you know who you are, Demons know who you are and they are afraid of you.
当你靠着主给你的权柄跟这个能力，你在赶鬼的时候，这个恶者认识你，这个背后的这个主权，他会认识你，他们会害怕你。
Sometimes I just touch a person, and if they have demons, the demon starts to manifest, like what happened last night.
这有时候我只是触摸某些人，他们如果有鬼附身的话，啊，就好像昨晚上发生的事。
Sometimes I walk into a room, the presence of God come, and the person will start to cry, and they just say, they don't even know who I am, and they just say, I want to know God. Can you pray for me?
这有时候我到一个地方、一个房间的时候，那些有邪灵在身上的人就开始哭泣，他就说我要更加认识神，请你帮助我。
So I'm saying this to you because I want you to understand that you are the carriers of God's presence, and that wherever you go, you bring the presence of Jesus with you, and you will see the power of God.
I mean, 我要这么告诉你，就是说你无论到哪里去，你要知道有圣灵与你同在，你有带着神给你的能力跟这个形象跟这个身份，所以你到哪里去，你就不要害怕。
Oh, I praise God, you know, wherever I go, I have heard different languages of worship. I have heard the African tongue, I have heard the Indian tongue, I have heard the tribal people, native people, different kind, Thai people, Indonesians, and of course, Mandarin this morning.
So, 感谢主，无论到哪里去服事，我听到有许许多的敬拜赞美的这个声音，用着不同的这个语言、不同的这个背景，来敬拜赞美，包括今天早上中文。
我不会讲华语，也会讲一点一点。
I do not know speak Mandarin. I know a little bit.
And so you know, I want you to understand that in heaven, when you go to heaven, you will hear the language of every tongue and every tribe. Because Philippians 2 verse 9 and 10 says, every tongue will what? Confess he is Lord. You will hear the language of all the people groups of the world.
在当你到天家的时候，天国其实他们有万国万民，用不同的这个声音，不同的这个语言来来敬拜赞美上帝。
And the good news is, in heaven, you understand every language.
And 在天国的时候，你能明白各种各样的这个言语。
You don't need interpretation.
你不需要这个翻译。
You'll be out of a job.
Yeah.
You understand every language in heaven.
你会明白在天国的这个语言。
Because there is no more division and there's no more separation, but unity in diversity.
因为不再有这个分党、分门结党，然后呢，合一是在那里的。
So heaven is a beautiful place.
说天堂是美好的。
Maybe someday I'll share more about heaven to you.
以后将来我会跟你分享更多有关天国的事。
I believe I will come back again.
我相信我会再次的回到这儿。
Unless you don't want to see me anymore.
除非你不要再见到我了。
And this morning,
今天早上,
as I seek the Lord on what He has for you,
在我在寻求神的面要跟大家分享什么的时候,
you see, I always ask the Lord.What he has, so that he will give you the bread of life that is tailor-made and cooked specially for you.
我经常问上帝说，我们应该怎么样来？上帝应该要按这个按时分粮，怎么样来按时分粮给大家特别的
？In every place that I travel, I always ask the Lord, Lord.What is a specific word for this city, for this church, for these people?
当我到不同城市的时候，我用中文上帝说：“这个神啊，你要对这个城市、对这个教会有什么特别的话吗？”
Hallelujah. Now I don't know much about the history of this church.
我不懂太多有关这间教会的这个背景和历史。
But what I saw in the spirit was that when the bricks and the foundation of this place was being laid,
当我看到一个景象就是说, 当这个建筑在建的时候, 那个砖块被垒起来的时候,
there were many people who agree with the building, and there were also many people who don't agree.
但很多人他赞同这个教会, 那时候同意, 也有很多人也不同意。
I don't know the history, but the Lord told me that there was some divisions and there were also some contention about Joy Center.
So, 我不知道这个其实发生什么事，但是神告诉我，这当初有一些的这个不同的声音。
And the Lord also revealed to me that there are also some from other churches who were a little bit envy or jealous about what is happening here.
有一些可能别的地方，别的教会，他们有一些不同的声音，或者可能有一些嫉妒的这个声音。
To the point that in the past history, there have been even church split and divisions because of what God is leading you guys into.
在早期可能还有一些 分离的这个事情,
Do you agree what I just said?
你同意我所说的吗?
And sometimes, I want you to understand this, sometimes we are called to please God and not to please man.
常常我们, 是被呼召, 我们要讨神喜悦, 不是讨人喜悦。
We don't live our Christian life under the opinions of people. We live under the dominion of God.
我们这个基督的生活，我们不是在乎这个顺从人的这个意见，乃是我们要顺服神的这个权柄。
So sometimes when we do things that is a little bit strange and it is out of the ordinary, people will question us and they will ask, why are you doing this? Why are you going there? Why are you doing things that we don't understand?
所以当时有时候我们做了一些比较出乎人意外的事情的时候，人会问，但是我们还是走着神要我们做的事。
Well, sometimes we don't need to understand everything.
有时候我们不需要明白所有的事情前因后果。
There were 12 disciples in the boat in the Sea of Galilee during the storm.
在这个12个门徒，他们在这个加利利，在这个暴风雨的晚上。
And all the 12 of them loved Jesus.
他们12个门徒都爱耶稣。
But only one disciple, Peter, stepped out of the boat and walked on water.
只有一个就是彼得，他走下那个船，然后走出去。
The rest of the 11, they did not. They stay in the boat.
剩下的十一个门徒，他们没有这么做，他们还是依然坐在这个船上。
But do they love Jesus?
但他们,
yes, very much.
他们爱耶稣吗? 他们的确是爱耶稣。
But it was only Peter who stepped out of the boat and walked on water.
但是只有彼得一个门徒，他下了船，然后走向耶稣，在水面上走。
And later on, the rest will understand.
过后呢，接下来的那些剩下十一个，他们就会明白了。
So I am called to be like what our elders say, an alarm clock.
所以我被呼召成为这个神的一个闹钟。
You know, alarm clock can be annoying.
这个闹钟其实可以很烦人的。Especially
when you want to sleep and the alarm clock starts to ring.
这个闹钟可能是大家不喜欢的，因为你要睡觉，那 alarm clock 一直在响。And
so sometimes when the church is slumbering and I start to ring, ding, wake up church. And sometimes to other people, it is annoying.
所以有时候教会在沉睡的当儿，我就扮演这个闹钟，把人家唤醒。但是有一群人是不喜欢的。
But the alarm clock is to wake you up, especially if your house is on fire.
这个闹钟就是要让你警醒的，让你醒过来， 特别是当你家着火的时候,
or when there is a thief that is coming into your house to steal from you, the alarm clock wakes you up.
或者有盗贼要到你家去偷东西, 这个, 闹钟就把你摇醒了。So
I am here to wake up the body of Christ.
所以我的责任是在这来叫醒这个基督的这个身体。
I'm here to tell you that this is high time to be awake.
我要告诉你这个是很应该警醒的时刻了。And
I am a forerunner, meaning that I'm a person who runs ahead of others.
我是在前线跑的，比你们走在更前面一些。To
show the way and to prepare the way.
来告诉你这个路，然后来准备那个路。
So that other people can follow.
所以让后来的人能够跟着走这条路。
Just very quickly go to Romans chapter 13 verse 11.
罗马书13章11节。
Romans 13 verse 11 says, and do this.
罗马书13章11节这么说。
Knowing the time, that now it is high time to what? Awake out of sleep. For now, our salvation speaks about the coming of the Lord draws nearer than when we first believe.
So, 罗马书13章11节说，再者你们晓得，现今就是该趁早睡醒的时候，因为我们得救，现今比初信的时刻更近了。
Verse 12,
12节,
the night is far spent, the day is at hand. And therefore, let us cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light.
12节这么说，黑夜已深，白昼将近，我们就当脱去暗昧的行为，带上光明的兵器。
So what time is it now?
So 现在是什么时刻了呢?
It's high time to wake up.
是这个应该趁早睡醒的时刻。
It's daylight time.
是一个白天啊。
Because in the next few years, the world is going to get very dark spiritually.
因为在接下来的几年，在灵命上，这个世界会变走进这个黑暗时刻。
Now, I'm not here to frighten you. I'm here to prepare you.
我不是为了要恐吓你，我是要来让你准备好你自己。
Things will become very dark in the next 3 to 4 years time.
接下来3到4年，这个情况会变得很黑暗，很糟糕。
Lawlessness will abound everywhere.
这个不法的事到处都会发生。
The love of many will grow cold.
这个很多人的爱心渐渐冷淡。
This is not my words. These are Jesus' words found in Matthew 24.
这不是我所讲的，这个是耶稣在马太福音20章那边所记载。
So we, the church, must be awake now. We must rise up and prepare ourselves for what is coming.
所以我们成为这个教会，基督身体，我们应该要警醒，来做好准备该做的事。
You know, the Lord teach us to pray.
耶稣教导我们怎么祷告。
And I have the whole biblical context of what it means to pray the Lord's Prayer in the book Lord teach us to pray. You need to get hold of that book.
所以我有本书解释到在圣经里拿出来说怎么教导你怎么来祷告的。
But one of the things that the Lord teach us to pray is that our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. And then it says what? Thy kingdom come. Come where? On earth, as it is in heaven.
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊父的名为圣。耶稣教导我们的这个主导文，愿你的这个旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。
Some Christians can't wait to die and go to heaven.
有一些基督徒很盼望赶紧死，然后去到天家。
But I have truth to tell you today. God wants you to bring heaven down to earth.
但是今天我告诉你，神要让 这个天国能够降在这个我们的人世间。
Did you just hear what I say?
你明白我要讲的东西吗？
Jesus teaches us to pray, Father, let your kingdom come on earth.
耶稣这么教导我们祷告，愿你的这个天国降临，临到地上。
Just as it is in heaven, let the same administration of heaven come on earth so that we can experience heaven on earth.
就好像天国就是降临到地上，所以我们在地上的时候也能够经历这个天国的这个一切的这个运作。
And when you bring heaven down to earth, you have what I call an awakening and a mighty outpouring of revivals.
当这个天国在地上运行的时候，你会看到好多好多复兴跟这个警醒，都人都醒过来。
And that revival, that awakening and that revival is going to happen here in Manjung and around the surrounding area of Stiawan.
Amen. 这个复兴将要临到这个 Stiawan, Manjung 这个地方，还有这个附近的这个地区。
That's why I come here today to wake you up.
所以今天我来到这个地方来把你叫醒。
I don't simply go and minister in any place unless the Lord asks me to go.
我一般不会就随着自己的意思去服侍哪个地方，除非上帝有指示。
I have invitations waiting for me in places like India and Pakistan and even in the Middle East. I say, Lord, I don't want to die young.
这我有一些邀请，然后在印度、巴基斯坦还有这个中东的地方，我跟神说，我不想这么年轻就死去。
There was a pastor who asked me 2 years ago, Pastor Terence, can you follow us to North Korea? I say, not yet.
就有一个说 ，Pastor Terence， 你跟我去朝鲜好吗？我说还不是时候。
Maybe one day I'll send Felix there. Hallelujah.
这有一天嘛，可能我会差遣Felix去。
North Korea, you ready for that?
那个朝鲜，你准备好了吗？
And so I came here today to wake you up and to prepare you that a mighty revival is about to happen here again, just as in the days of John Song.
这个我来这里来提醒你，让你准备好，因为这个大复兴将会来到这个地方，就好像。 早期的宋三杰博士的时代
So prepare yourself.
所以准备好你自己吧。
Last night we ended by telling you that you need to redig your wells.
昨天晚上我们跟大家分享说，我们要重掘，重新挖我们自己这口井。
Because the enemy likes to fill up our wells with earth.
因为这个恶者喜欢用那些土。 把我们的这口井给堵着。And
earth represents the things of the earth.
这个土就表示这个世界上的东西。And
I also mentioned that the well represents your word life and your worship life.
这个那口井也预表着你的这个生活，还有你这个敬拜赞美读经的这个生活。
You know, the Lord knows that I love poetic words, flowery words that rhymes.
就神知道我很喜欢一些有押韵的一些字眼，这些文学上的一些押韵的字眼。
When you read my books, you will understand. It's full of poems, poetic, flowery words.
当你读我的书，你就知道我比较喜欢用一些有押韵的一些字眼，漂亮的一些文学上的字眼。
And I am kind of like a psalmist, ones who sing new songs unto the Lord every morning.
就我好像一个诗人哈，就早上我们也可以对向着主来唱这个新歌。
But those songs, many of them were not recorded. My wife has got 2 albums. One is in the process, but most of the songs that we sung has never been recorded, but they are recorded in heaven.
这个我有唱了很多这个新歌，然后我太太有把它一部分给它记录下来，然后录制下来。然后呢，其实我们很多歌没有录制下来，但是 以后在天堂会被录制。
You know, in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18,
这个以弗所书5章18节,
Ephesians 5:18, it tells us that we are 5:18 of Ephesians, hallelujah, praise God. And it says that we are to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
就是我们要被这个圣灵来充满。
You see that? We must be filled with the Spirit, with the Holy Spirit.
是哪要被圣灵充满。
The word fill there in the Greek is the word pleroo.
在希腊文它是
pleroo.
Pleroo.
Any word in the Greek that ends with two O is a present continuous tense.
在这个希腊文，这个如果有两个O，它是现代进行式。
Meaning that it's not past tense. In the English here is past tense, but in the Greek, pleroo means to be continuously filled all the time.
这个在希腊文，这个fill这个字，这里是英文是已经成型了，但是希腊文是它继续。 不停地被浇灌,
so if you are filled with the Holy Spirit last night, you need to be filled with the Holy Spirit today, and you need to be filled tomorrow, and every other day until Jesus comes back.
So 你昨天被圣灵充满,
but many Christians today, they come on Sunday, they get filled, but then Monday to Saturday, they get unfilled.
但是很多基督徒星期天来这里被圣灵充满，但是星期一到星期六他们就腾空了。And
then they come on Sunday to get refilled again, and then the next day unfilled.
在星期天再来，然后第二天又空了。But
we are called to be filled every day continuously.
我们被呼召是要每一天每时刻都不停地被圣灵充满着。
And notice the word there, there is a comma after the word Spirit, comma. Now look at verse 19. That is the evidence that you are filled with the Holy Spirit. Verse 19 now, you'll be speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs and singing melody in your heart to God.
这个接下来19章19节说当用 诗章、颂词、灵歌，彼此对说，口唱心和的赞美主。
Sometimes when you are so full of the Holy Spirit, you cannot stop, but you just want to sing.
有时候圣灵充满你，你这么喜乐，你就是要敬拜赞美，你要赞美，要唱歌。
So now you understand why some Christians they come to church they cannot sing because empty tank.
你就可以明白为什么一些基督徒来到教会，他们唱不出歌，唱不出来赞美神，因为他没有被圣灵充满。When
your tank is empty, nothing comes out.
因为你这个 tank 已经空了，空了你就根本没有东西可以出来。And
some Christians, oh, they are like a big, beautiful sports car, you know, Porsche. Wow.
有一些看起来外表是一个很大的一个。 这个跑车也好，这个。
But what good is that beautiful car if there is no petrol, the car cannot move.
但是总变你是这个跑车也好，肌肉车也好，但是你没有这个油，这辆车是跑不起来的。
Other form, tada function.
这个有一个样貌，但是没有这个能力，没有这个功能。
So some Christians, they look so good on the outside like a beautiful sport car.
这一些基督徒外表看起来是很好的。 好像一辆跑车，外面看起来是很好的。
But inside, 过松。
但是在里头是空的。
That's why they cannot even make melody in their heart to God.
所以就是这样的原因，他们连唱歌敬拜赞美神都做不出来。
But when you are filled with the Holy Spirit,
但是当你被圣灵所充满的时候，
songs bubble up inside of you.
这个诗歌就会在从你心里头。
And every day you want to just sing to the Lord and worship.
你会很自然的每天都想要唱歌敬拜上帝。
All right, that is the introduction.
那是开场白。
Oh Lord, they all look at me with very serious face. Hallelujah.
认真地看着我, huh?
We need to go back to the Bible.
我们要回到神的话当中, 圣经当中。
Apostle Paul, when he preached for 9 hours.
这个保罗, 使徒保罗, 他分享的时候, 他讲了9个小时。
Until a person fell down from the window because fell asleep.
直到有一个人从这个那边高处掉下来, 因为睡着了。
And fell down dead, and Apostle Paul has to go down there and to raise him up from the dead, and he continued to preach.
是那个人掉下来了, 死了, 然后保罗过去把, 为他祷告, 他又活过来, 然后保罗接着, 分享。
So this morning, if you fall off your chair, we'll come and raise you up. Hallelujah.
所以今天早上如果你从椅子上掉下来, 神会帮你。
I'm just kidding, you know, you are very good people. I'll be good to you.
是, 我只是开玩笑这么说, 哈。
And if you do happen to come to Penang,
如果你, 有机会到 Penang 来的话,
please come and visit us at Asia Revival Center.
请来, 欢迎你们来拜访我们, 我们在 亚洲这复兴中心,
you have the internet connection, right, on your media. Yeah. If you can type Asia Revival Center, you can just show them the website quickly because there is so much resources there.
你如果可以现在就登上这个互联网，打这个 Asia Revival Center， 然后你可以看到里头有很多这个资源。
You know, everywhere I go, especially Ipoh, KL, Cantonese speaking, they call me the Min Bao Lou.
Oh, I'm,
so I got so much Min Bao. That's it. You just go to just put that on. Can you display that? That's Asia Revival Center.
那是亚洲复兴中心。
Right? So if you go there, you will see there's a lot of resources on the end times, on the word and spirit, on Elijah Academy, on sermons, and everything is all there. You know, just go to the website, you will be blessed. I'm introducing you. Go back to the top. Go back to the top. So that is the, if you just show the sanctuary, that is the sanctuary.
是那个是,
that is the sanctuary. So, you know, people just come and people just be filled and they will just fall everywhere and the Lord will just touch them. People will just be blessed. And there's so much resources, so much resources. I'm introducing you to a bakery.
So, 这里有很多资源, 我正在带领你这介绍你这个有关这个我们的 面包房,
because I can't give you all the bread today. I'm only going to give you 2 slices.
今天我只能给你两片面包, 这里有更多的这个资源。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So if you do come to Penang, come and visit us.
如果你, 有来槟城, 你可以来, 欢迎你们来拜访我们。
And while you are here, you can always go to the website. All those materials are free.
这些所有的资讯资, 资源都是免费的。
We are called to be a blessing to the body of Christ.
我们被呼召来祝福这个神的这个肢体。
Okay, are you ready for the word? 2 slices of bread, and then we are done.
你准备好了吗? 两片面包, 然后我们就结束了。
Oh, glory to God.
荣耀给上帝。
I am enjoying this. I don't know about you.
我是很, 享受这时刻, 我不懂你是怎么样想的。
Let's go to John chapter 4.
约翰福音第4章。
So let's look at John chapter 4. Let's start from verse 4 onwards.
第4节开始。
Jesus needed to go through Samaria.
耶稣必须经过撒玛利亚。
Correction, he don't need to.
要更正哈, 其实他不需要的。
If you look at the biblical map,
如果你看这个圣经上的一个地图,
from Judea to Galilee,
从犹太到这个加利利,
during Jesus' time, about 2,000 years ago,
大概2000年前,
they have what is called the main route that will take you from Judea to Galilee, and you don't have to pass through Samaria.
就有一个主道和主要的道路，他可以带你从这个犹大走到这个加利利，不需要经过这个撒玛利亚的。
Especially for the Jewish people, they don't want to go to Samaria because they consider the Samaritans people as a people who are defiled. They are half Jewish and half Goyim, which is the Hebrew word for Gentiles.
这个因为特别是那当时代这个犹太人，他们不要去撒玛利亚那个地方，因为他们看撒玛利亚人是不纯种的，因为他们是一半，就通跟外邦人通婚的下一代。
In fact, it is even unlawful for a Jew to talk to a Samaritan. You know that?
但是的这个规定好像这个犹太人都不被容许跟撒玛利亚人交谈。
So Jesus could have bypassed Samaria and just go straight to Galilee, but the Bible say he needed to go to Samaria.
其实啊，耶稣可以直接知道这个加利利去了，但是圣经记载说他。 需要经过撒玛利亚绕道到那里去。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because Jesus only do what he sees the Father do, remember?
因为耶稣做他父亲要他所做的事。
And the Father sees a woman at a well, and the Father spoke to the Son and said, Son, you need to go and meet this woman.
所以天父看到撒玛利亚有一个妇人家， 需要得到救，然后这个耶稣，他就叫这个耶稣，你必须要走去撒玛利亚。
So I want you to know that God will always go out of the way to meet with you.
So 天父他会常常用一个我们所想象不了、不明白的方式来叫我们做一些事。
Wherever there is a need, the Lord will come to meet that need.
所以哪里有这个需要，神就会用透过方式来解决那边的这个需要。And
not only that, but now look at verse 5, John 4, verse 5. So he came to a city of Samaria, which is called Stiawan.
这个撒玛利第五节他说，于是到了撒玛利一座城，名叫石造园。
Not Stiawan, Sika, sorry.
Sika,
Are you all still awake?
Sika.
The word Sika in the Hebrew means the end of a land, the ending part, the last part or the end of a road.
这个Sika在圣经的解释，它是说那个地方是在那个路的最尾端、最末端。So
not only that Jesus now pass through Samaria, but he purposely go to a city that is at the end of the road that nobody wants to go to.
但不然单单他要经过这个撒玛利亚，他还走到这个西加这个地方。那个西加是在路的最尾端，其实一般人是不要走的。So
he's totally out of his way.
他就真的是不在他的路上了，走到别的地方去了。Because
there was a woman at a well.
因为在那里有一个妇人家在井旁。And
the Bible tells us that this woman also went out of her way.
这个也，圣经教导我们说，那个妇人家也在走到那个地方了。Let's
read on and I'll explain to you.
我们继续读，我来跟你解释。Verse
6, now Jacob's well was there. Jesus therefore, being wearied from his journey, sat thus by the well, it was about the sixth hour, and verse 7, a woman of Samaria came to draw water.
第六节，在那里有雅各井，耶稣因走路困乏，就坐在井边。那时约有午正，有一个撒玛利亚的妇人来打水。So
the Bible tells us, it gives us a description here that this is called Jacob's well.
这个圣经这么讲说，那口井叫雅各井。
Now, in biblical time, at the gates of every city, there is always a well.
在这个圣经的时代，在这个城门的那边，那里外有都有一口井的。
Two times a day, once in the morning, once in the evening, the people of the city will go to the city gates to take water from the well.
所以一天两次，早晨一次。 这个城里的人会到这个井那里去拿这个水。
You see an example of this in Genesis 24, where the servant of Abraham, Eliezer, went to the city gates and then Rebekah came to draw water, remember?
So, 你知道这个马城的仆人他在那边去打水的时候，那个利百加也去打水，就是这个一个意思，那个时刻。
So this woman of Samaria, she could have just go to the city gates and there is the well there. She could have taken water and go back to her house.
这个撒玛利亚的妇人，她可能就是到这个城门口那边去打水就回家了。
But the Bible says she went to this well of Jacob, who is at a mountain. So she also went out of her way.
这个圣经这么讲，他这个雅各井是在比较偏远的，然后这个妇人家也是跑到比较远的地方去取水去打水。
And because she went out of her way, God also went out of His normal way and came to that well to meet that woman.
所以这个妇人家她走到不寻常的路，走这么远的地方，主耶稣他也知道这件事，他也特地走到那个地方去见她。
Today, some of you here are visitors.
今天这里在座的有一些可能是拜访的，来这里拜访的。
You're supposed to be somewhere else, but you went out of your way and you came here to Shekinah Methodist Center.
你一般这个时候应该在别的地方，但是今天你特别的跑来这个地方。
So because you went out of your way and you came here, God also is going go. He went out of His way and He's coming here to meet you today.
因为你走了你不寻常的时刻，你今天来到这里，神也会来到这里来，让你遇见。
So Jesus went to Sychar, a city at the end of the road.
所以耶稣来到这个叙加这个地方，这个叙加是在路的最尾端的一个小地方。
And now this woman, verse 7,
第七节,
came to the well, and Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink."
So 有一个撒玛利亚妇人来打水，耶稣对她说，请你给我水喝。
So verse 9, and the woman of Samaria said to Jesus, "How is it that you, being a Jew, ask a drink from me, a Samaritan woman, for Jews have no dealings with Samaritans." You see that?
So, 这个撒玛利亚妇人第九节对耶稣说：“你既是犹太人，怎么向我一个撒玛利亚妇人要水喝呢？原来犹太人和撒玛利亚人没有来往。”
So the Jewish people don't want to go to Samaria.
这个犹太人不要去撒玛利亚。
But Jesus went there to meet with one woman.
但是主耶稣特地的。 安排走到去那里去见这个妇人家。
Because there is something about this woman that draws the attention of God.
因为这个妇人的事情，特别的让神注意到她。
And Jesus waited for her to come.
主耶稣等这个妇人来。
And when she came, Jesus tested her and said, "Hey, give me a drink."
So 他来的时候，主耶稣就跟他说：“哎，你请你给我水喝。”
Verse 10, and Jesus answered and said to her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is who's talking to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water."
第十节，耶稣回答说：“你若知道神的恩赐。” 和对你说给我水喝的是谁，你必早求他，他也必早给你活水。So
I call this, you know, the English word icebreaker.
我就说这是一个好像破冰的环节。When
you want to talk to a stranger, you do not know what to say, so you bring an icebreaker. You break the ice so that it's like, for example, you know, you want to talk to a stranger. Excuse me, what time is it? Well, today very hot. Oh, it's going to rain. You know, icebreaker.
So, 好像开场白或者一个破冰的环节，常常一个对一个陌生人，你说不好意思打扰一下，请问现在几点呢？或者你说，哎，今天天气不错嘛，等等，就可以开始一个谈话了。
So Jesus did an icebreaker with her and said, hey, give me a drink. But the truth is, Jesus was the one who wants to give her a drink.
就耶稣就用这个说，哎，请你给我水喝，来做一个开场白，一个破冰环节。但其实耶稣他真正是要把水给这个女的喝。
Last night I say, if you are hungry, God is going to feed you.
昨晚上我说，如果你是渴慕神的话，渴慕的话，神会喂饱喂养你。
So usually after you have eaten, you get thirsty, right?
一般上我们吃饱了过后，我们都会觉得口渴。
So this morning I want to ask you, are you thirsty?
今天早上我要问你，你口渴吗？
Because if you are thirsty, God is going to give you a drink.
因为如果你口渴的话，神将会给你这个水。
Yesterday he gave you food, today he gave you drink. He's
昨天他给你这个粮，今天给你这个水。
Hallelujah, Lord. And now the Lord says in verse 10, if you know the gift of God,
他这里说你若知道神的恩赐,
and if you know who I am, Jesus talking here, if you know who this Jesus is, then you will have the boldness, you will have the hunger and the thirst to come and say, Lord, I want everything that you have for me.
So, 如果你早知道你知道我是谁，这个跟你说话这耶稣是谁，你就早就会跟我要求说，或者知道这个你要跟我拿这个活水。
The more you experience Jesus, the more you want Jesus.
你越经历主耶稣，你越需要主耶稣与你同在。
The more you have tasted that the Lord is good, the more you want to taste Him because He is sweet and He is good.
更多的你经历了神的这个甘甜跟美好，你要经历更多更多神的这个美好。
If you know who Jesus is,
如果你真真确确认识主耶稣是谁的话,
you will ask more from him.
你会更多、更经常、更多的要向他来求求。
Because he has so much more that he wants to give to you.
因为他有这么多的资源，他要给你。
And so, let's just fast forward because of time. And now Jesus said in verse 13, Jesus said to her, whoever drink of this natural water from Jacob's well will thirst again. Verse 14, but whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst, but the water I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life.
十三节耶稣回答说凡喝这水的还要再渴。十四节人若喝我所赐的水就永远不渴，我所赐的水要在他里头成为源泉，直涌到永生。
So if you drink Chinese tea, you drink Coca-Cola, you drink mineral water, you drink 100 plus, you drink all the natural drinks, you still get thirsty.
如果你喝茶、喝汽水、喝等等的东西，你还是会口渴的。
But if you drink from the fountain of life,
但是你如果从这个生命的源泉那边来喝这个水的话,
that fountain will quench your thirst.
这个源泉 永恒的源泉将会让你永远不渴。
And that fountain will draw you to a greater river.
这个源泉将会带领你到更好的这个水源。
The more you drink from Jesus, the more you will pant for him like a deer pants for the water.
你越多的喝这个从主耶稣来的这个泉源, 你就会好像那个小鹿这样更加渴慕这个溪水。
So let's continue, and now verse 15, and the woman said to him, sir, give me this water that I may not thirst, nor come here to draw.
So 15节，妇人说，先生，请把这个水赐给我，叫我不渴，也不用来这么远打水。
And Jesus said to her, go, call your husband, and come here.
耶稣说，十六节, And the
woman answered and said, I have no husband.
这个妇人回答说,
and Jesus said to her, you have well said, I have no husband.
耶稣对他说, 你说没有丈夫是不错的。
And verse 18,
18节,
for you have had five husbands, and the one whom you now have is not your husband.
18节, 你已经有五个丈夫, 你现在有的并不是你的丈夫。
And now the woman says, sir, you must be a prophet. You know everything about me.
这个妇人就说, 先生, 我看出你是先知。 你知道我的背景。
Now, I want to just zoom in here.
我让你好好的在这一点上看。
And introduce this woman to you.
要介绍这个妇人家, 让你更加了解。
We have been taught from Sunday school until now that this woman is an adulterous woman. She got five husbands and the sixth one, she's living with a man.
我们从小主日学开始就被教导这个 妇人家好像就是一个犯奸淫的, 她有五个丈夫, 然后现在有第六个。
I happen to sit under the feet of a very well-known Jewish rabbi.
我曾经有跟一个 拉比, 犹太的拉比, 在他的脚下的门跟他交谈学习。
Who teaches about the Jewish culture in biblical times.
在, 教导我们当时耶稣时代的这个犹太人的这个传统, 还有文化。
In biblical time, when you live in a village,
在这个 圣经时代的时代，你如果住在这个村庄乡下，
the village is all your own relative, your cousins, long lost uncle and new found aunties.
这个 在村庄里头呢，就住在你的一些 亲戚或者远房亲戚，你的一些家人们这样的。
Everybody is related.
好像每个人都是你的亲戚或者有关联的。
So it is impossible for a woman to marry five times to a stranger. It is totally against the culture of the biblical times.
所以在圣经时代，其实是不可能，也不容许让这个妇人家也不会发，不可能发生，就是说她嫁给五个陌生人，没有关联的人。
So why did the Bible say that she got five husbands and the sixth one is not her husband?
为什么这里就说她有五个丈夫，但是第六个不是她的先生？
It is the law of Moses. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 25, verse 6.
我们去到这个生命记。
Deuteronomy 25, verse 6.
25章第6节。
And look at what the law of Moses required.
就看这个摩西的这个, 律法是怎么样记载的。
Deuteronomy 25:6a, it shall be that the firstborn son which she bears will succeed to the name of his dead brother, that his name may not be blotted out of Israel. Now verse 6, and it shall be that the firstborn son which has been, which she bears will also succeed to the name of his dead brother, that his name may not be blotted out of Israel. And verse 7, but if the man does not want to take his brother's wife, then let his brother's wife go up to the gate to the elders and say, my husband's brothers refuse to raise up a name to his brother in Israel, and he will not perform the duty of my husband's brother. So there is a law in the law of Moses that when a brother dies, the next brother must marry the widow.
So, 在摩西的律法当中，就说一个长兄如果他死了过后，他的这个妻子就要嫁给他的这个长兄的弟弟。
And if the second brother also died, the third brother must marry her.
第二个如果也死了，第三个也要这个要娶她。
So if the third brother also died, the fourth brother must marry her.
So 就是这样跟着下去，第三、第四如果都死了，他要接着下去。
So in this case, she married all the five brothers according to the law of Moses. So all the five brothers died. The sixth brother say, "Hey, 冇搞错啊你。"
So
All my five brothers married you, all also die. I'm the sixth one, I marry you. After I also die, better not marry you.
So he said,
She was just obeying the law of Moses.
她只是跟随着摩西的这个律法去做。
Because the law of Moses required that when a brother died, the next brother must marry the widow. So five brothers marry her, all the five brothers died, and the sixth one now said, I am not going to marry this woman, but she can stay, because in Deuteronomy 55, in verse 8, you know, the elders can now say that, oh, this woman, you don't want to marry, but you must still take care of her. So she stays in the house with the sixth brother, but the sixth brother was not her husband.
So, 他是说他们还有另外一条意思说他可以第六个他不要嫁给他，但是他可以照顾着他住在他们的家里。
Now I'm painting a whole new picture for you to see who this woman is.
So 我现在再一次的把这个整个图画重新的画了给你们看。
Because we always assume, oh, got five husbands now living with a man, we assume that she is committing adultery. Jesus never says she committed adultery, you know. Read the Bible clearly.
如果你好好读圣经，这里从来没有说过她是一个犯奸淫的一个女人。
And another thing that I want you to know about Jewish culture,
我让你知道这个犹太人的这个文化传统,
the well of Jacob is a holy site.
这个雅各井是一个神圣的一个地方,
it's a religious well.
是一个, 宗教性的一个, 一口井。
The law of Moses also said that if an adulteress or harlot who is unclean cannot touch anything that's clean, they will be stoned to death.
这个摩西的律法也有记载说，如果那些不洁净的或者犯奸淫的、有罪的人，不能到那个神圣的地方，不然会被用石头打死。
So if this woman is a harlot or an adulteress and she goes to the well of Jacob, the village will stone her to death.
如果这个妇人家是这个 犯奸淫的，然后他又到那个地方去的话，他就会被人村民把这个石头把他打死。
And the third point,
第三点,
when she encountered Jesus, she went back to her village, remember?
当她遇见耶稣过后，她就回到
And she told the village, hey, I have met the Messiah, come and follow me.
她告诉村里的人说，哎，我遇见了弥赛亚，来跟随我吧。
And the whole village believed her and followed her.
And 整个村庄的人相信她，也跟随她。
The third Jewish culture, third point of a Jewish culture. If she is a harlot, she cannot speak in public to a public in a public square to the village, and the villagers will not believe her if she is a woman of sin.
如果她是一个犯罪、犯奸淫的女人，她在这个她的村庄里头，她是不容许。 在大众广下跟这么多人说话，他们也不会相信他的。So
now do you understand who she is?
所以你更加明白这个妇人家是谁吗？
She cannot be an adulteress because the Jewish culture does not allow a woman to marry strangers five times. It is not allowed.
这个在当时的背景下，他们是不容许一个女人嫁给五个陌生人的。
She cannot be an adulteress because she cannot go to the holy well of Jacob. She will be stoned to death.
她因为她不可能是犯奸淫的，不然她就不可以到这个那个神圣的这个雅各井那边去，不然她会被打死。
And she will not have the authority to speak in a public place to the village because they will not believe an adulteress.
And 她也不会有这个权利或者这个自由在这个大庭广众跟这么多人说话，叫他们来听从她，他们也不会相信她。
That's why it's very important we understand the culture of the people to understand the word of God.
So 我们必须要很清楚地知道，明白这个当时的背景跟文化。
So who is this woman?
So 这个女人是谁呢？
She was just a woman who is hungry to worship God.
她只是一个单纯的一个女人，她这个很要渴慕来敬拜赞美上帝。
Look what the Bible says.
就看圣经怎么说吧。
Verse 20.
第20节。
Our fathers worship on this mountain.
我们的祖先在这个山上礼拜。
What mountain was that?
哪一座山呢？
The mountain where the well of Jacob was, right?
就是这个雅各井在的地方。
So the Samaritans people go up to that mountain to where the well is, and they worship there because the woman says, "Our father worship at this mountain."
So 这个撒玛利亚人来到这雅各井这边这座山上面，他说我们的祖辈们在这里来敬拜神。
So it's very clear the reason why she went up there is because she wants to worship God and also draw some water for herself.
So 很清楚的，她去那边就是为了敬拜神，也要拿一些水，打一些水。
And out of that context, Jesus now said to her, "Woman," verse 21, "believe the hour is coming that when you will neither on this mountain or in Jerusalem worship the Father."
So 21节，耶稣说：“妇人，你当信我，时候将到，你们拜父也不在这山上，也不在耶路撒冷。”
And of course, Jesus go on to say that the Father is looking for worshippers who worship in spirit and truth.
So, 接着耶稣说，神喜悦这个用心灵和诚实来敬拜神的。
Now, I studied church history.
我读过教会的这个历史。
And there were four early letters written by the fathers in the first and the second century.
就有四个很早期的这个字在。 早期的这个第一、第二世纪写的一些东西。
And they named this woman as Botini. That's her name.
这个妇人家她的名字，他们记载这个女的名字叫 Botini.
And the early fathers say that she became a mighty evangelist.
这个早期的记载有说她过后成为这个很有能力的这个宣教的人。
They even say that she was at the upper room, the 120, at the upper room when the Holy Spirit came. She was also there.
犹太人的历史书也记载说，在马可楼的时候，等这五旬节等候圣灵的时候，她也是其中一个。
And in one of those early letters by the early fathers, they say that Potini became so in love with Jesus after she encountered Jesus at the well.
So, 她有被记载在一封书信上面说，当这波提尼遇见这个耶稣过后，她也很爱着耶稣。
You know, immediately after that, she went back to the village Sychar and she brought her entire village, the whole village experienced a revival.
So, 你知道她有记载过后，这个女的，她妇人，她马上回到她村庄，把所有的人都叫出来。
It's like today you come and encounter Jesus and you go back. Tomorrow the whole of Manjung and Stiawan will encounter a revival.
So, 好像你今天遇到耶稣，你回到曼荣，明天整个曼荣都复兴了。
They don't say Amen or Lord.
Amen.
Are you all still alive?
你还活着吗？
Don't you want to see revival in your village, in your town?
你不要看到有复兴吗？
So this woman encountered Jesus, and after that, she went back to her village. She brought her entire village to meet with the Lord.
这个女妇人她遇到耶稣，然后她马上回到她村庄，把所有的人叫出来，来遇见耶稣。
The early fathers said that she even went to Rome to evangelize to the Roman Emperor Nero.
这个早期的书信还有记载说，这个我听你也有到这个罗马帝国那边去，尼罗那个他的国王有在那边去宣教。And
Nero put her in prison and had the Roman soldiers beat her up so badly.
这个尼罗这个罗马君王把他抓了，把他关进监牢里来虐打他。
To make her stop talking about Jesus.
让他停止宣讲耶稣的事。
But she starts sharing Christ to her Roman soldiers, and all those Roman soldiers believe her, and they got converted.
So, 很多他在监狱里的时候跟他们分享这个跟那个罗马军兵来讲这个耶稣，他们也很多一些也相信了。
And then Nero was thinking, if I cannot torture her, maybe I bribe her.
这个尼罗这个国王说，如果不能虐待他，可能我可以这个贿赂他。
So Nero brought out all those treasures and the best silk garment to give to her and say, stop talking about Jesus. I will give you all these treasures.
这个国王就说，他把一些珍贵的宝藏拿出来说，如果你不再讲耶稣这些，我可以让你拿走。
And she put all those treasures away and she showed Nero because she was wearing a prison cloth, rags. And she said, you look at me in my prison rag, but I am wearing a robe of righteousness.
他说，你看到我可能是穿一个破衣，监狱的衣，但是我是穿着这个公义圣洁的这个有个外表。
And because of her passion, scholars said that even Nero's daughter became a believer because of this woman, Potini.
这个学者的一些记载，他说，因为这个Potini的这个作为，这个尼罗国王的这个女儿也成了一个信主的人。
And finally,
最后
they caught her.
他们抓到她。
And they put her inside a dry well.
他们把她放在一口这个干的这个井里头。
They threw her inside into a dry well, just like Joseph was put in a pit. They threw her inside a dry well.
他把她丢在一个干的井。
And she died.
她就死在那。
And before she died, she said this.
当他死之前，他这么有。
This was recorded by the early father Eusebius in his letters to the church.
这个在有一个Eusebius这个神父他写给教会的一封信上面里头记载的。
Before she died, she said this.
他当这个妇人死之前，他有这么说。
I cannot live in a well that is dry and empty. I'd rather die.
我情愿死，我不要在一个空的，而且是干的一口井里面活着，我情愿死去。
They beat her up, she cannot die. They torture her, she cannot die. But they put her in a dry well that is empty, she died.
他们打她，虐待她，她还活着，还活下来，但是他们把她放在一口干的井里头，她就选择死了。
Why?
为什么？
Because she has tasted the living water at a well that is full of living water, and she's used to water in the well. So when you put her in a well where there is no water, she died.
因为她曾经尝过这个有这个泉源的这个水，然后她也尝过，所以你把她放在一个干枯的，她就死了。
That's Potini.
这是 Potini.
I have tasted the goodness of God.
我已经享受过，尝过神的美好。
I have tasted the sweetness of God.
我已经尝过神来的这个甜美。
I have seen Jesus 3 times personally.
我看过耶稣三次。
And I always tell people this, if you take my Jesus away from me, let me die.
我常这么说，如果你让耶稣从我这里离去的话，
You can give me the whole world and all the gold and silver and all the millions. I don't want that. I want my Jesus.
Amen. 你可以把世界所有的东西都拿去，我都不在乎，但是我要耶稣。
He's more than enough.
他就有耶稣就足够了。
He is our real thing.
他是我们的真实的王。
He is the real thing. It's not Coca-Cola.
他是真实的，不是假的。
If you take Jesus away from me, I'd rather die.
如果你把耶稣从我生命中拿开，我情愿死。
And I want you to get this today, that Jesus is the most important person in your life.
我要你今天确认也知道，耶稣一定是你生命中最重要的一个人。
Not your husband, not your wife, not your children, not your property, not your bank account, not everything that the world can give you, but Jesus is the reason for your living.
不是你的先生或者你的妻子，不是你的孩子，不是你的房子，不是你的产业，不是你的一切，但是是耶稣。
And this woman, Potini, she had tasted and encountered God at a well, and she had drunk from the well of living water that when the Roman soldiers put her in an empty well with no water, finally she gave her spirit back to the Lord and died.
So Potini, she had tasted and encountered God at a well, and she had drunk from the well. 经历过耶稣，然后呢，这个他把罗马军把他放在一个干枯的井边的时候，他就选择把灵魂交给上帝，死了。
Our life on this earth，
我们的一生，我们的生命在这世界上
，is to fellowship with God，
是为了要我们跟神有认识神，并且跟神有这个fellowship。
And to glorify God.
并且让透过神，我们能够荣耀我们的生命，荣耀神。
You are made for Him.
你和我都被因着神创造来为着荣耀神的名。
All things according to Colossians chapter 1, we don't have time to go there.
哥罗西书第一章。
All things were made for Him by Him, and it is in Him that all things consist.
So, 一切的一切都是借着他，也从他那里被创造的，也为着他而被造创造的。
Just for your reference, that's Colossians 1:15-16. But today, I want to pray for you.
哥罗西书1:15-16哈，但是今天我要为你祷告。
That you will be so in love with Jesus.
祷告让你这么的会深深的爱耶稣。
That even one day without Jesus, you will feel like you cannot survive.
就是连一天你没有耶稣，你会觉得你不能活下去。
The Lord called me many years ago to be a prophet to the nations.
很多年前，主召我成为这个国家的这个一个。
And I live my life every day hearing the voice of God.
So 我每一天的生活，都听神的这个声音。
And if I don't hear His voice for one day,
如果我一天没有听到神跟我说话，
I feel like dying.
我就感觉很好像要死去一样。
I feel like I'm lost.
我感觉就我没有了方向。
I feel alone.
我感觉很孤单。
And there was a time in my life many years ago when I did not hear God's voice for a few days.
在生命当中有一段时间，我好像有好多几天没有听到神的声音。
It was the most terrible moments of my life.
那几天是我生命中很糟糕的几天。
Because His voice is sweeter than a honeycomb.
因为他的话，神的声音。
My Lord, My Lord.
蜜蜂甜，更加甘甜。
And what I carry with me today, I want to leave with you before I go back to Penang.
今天我所带来的东西，就是我所拥有的。我要告诉你，也教导你，当我回槟城之前。
I want to give to you this. Passionate love for Jesus.
我要让你有个这个很渴慕对神的这个爱。
That you will be so passionate about this Jesus that every day you will want to go to His Word to hear His voice. You want to worship Him to hear Him. You want to walk worthy of Him and please Him. That you just want to sit at His feet like Mary.
每一天你都很渴慕神的话。 每天你都很渴慕跟他交谈，来敬拜赞美他，来跟着他的引导，就好像这个 Mary， 她愿意坐在主的跟前听他的话。
Why is this so important?
为什么这是这么重要呢?
Because the Lord spoke to me and said, you cannot steward, manage a revival without first being in love with Jesus.
因为主耶稣告诉我，清楚告诉我说， 你如果没有跟主联合的话， 你不可能靠着自己能力去把这个复兴做出来的。
Because if you don't fall in love with Jesus, you can fall in love with a revival.
Yeah, 因为你这个如果没有爱上耶稣的话， 你就会不可能
I pray that makes sense to them, Lord. Lord, help me here.
我盼望这个是你们能够明白的,
Sometimes we love the blessings of God. God, you bless me. Oh, God, you heal me. God, you give me. We love all those gifts that God gives us, and they are good.
常常我们说主啊, 你祝福我, 你给我这个健康, 你给我这个等等等等, 我们都很喜欢神的这个祝福, 这些是没错。
But we must not love the gifts more than we love the giver.
当我们不应该单单仰望喜欢这神给我们的礼物，多过我们喜欢爱神。
And Jesus wants you all today to fall head over heels in love with Him again. Go back to your first love. Love the Lord your God with all your heart.
今天就简单来说，就是神要我们 回到我们初时对神的那个爱，深深的爱着耶稣。
Because he loved to give gifts to his lovers.
因为他喜欢给他所爱的人这个礼物。
Can we all just stand on our feet?
我们可以站起来。
Worship team, can I ask you all to come? The worship team.
敬拜赞美团可以上来吗?
There was a song that you were singing just now. Jesus, Jesus, call on his name. And can you just sing that in English so that everybody can understand? Thank you. Call on Jesus. Call on him.
我们可以呼叫耶稣。
we're going to sing that again, but very quickly. Whatever your need is, you need prayer today, just come up here quickly and stand in one line.
你有什么要祷告的，你今天可以来到前面， 就站一,
whether it's because of healing or you want God to fill you
医治的,
with more of His river, more of Jesus, just come up here and just stand in one long line. Just come to the Lord, come to the well.
就来到这口井前。
And as they come, let's continue to sing and worship the Lord.
I humbly come to you.
I humbly come to seek your face. Come and fill me up.
If those of you want to come, just come. Just come to the well. Come out of your way, and God will go out of His way to meet you.
So, 你要走不同的路，耶稣也会来找你。
Come and just tell Him that you want more of Him.
你告诉主神，我要更多的经历你。
To be more in love with Jesus.
我要更加的爱你。
同在，求你接近我，来充满我。是。